this is the first outing of Agro Innovate. And this is a forum where you bring all, virtually all the stakeholders together for collaboration, for partnership. It will expose the business people to all the new areas of opportunity where they can actually gain and make business. I think it's a very good and wonderful forum for Nigeria.
Ordinarily, I would have said I'm one of the unrecognized organizers, because actually the story about AgroVate started when I visited Dubai early this year. So there was an AgroVate, there was an exhibition organized by the same informal group in Dubai that I attended. That is the biggest exhibition of agriculture in the Middle East. So follow up to that, we demanded that we need something like that in West African sub-region. So we started speaking, and I can say David Rose, who happened to be the project lead for this particular AgroVate in Nigeria, kept on talking since that time to bring that kind of experience to Nigeria. It is a good one. It's a good start in Dubai. We have over 200 exhibitors, and here I'm saying less than that. But I want to believe that in Nigeria we need to start somewhere. People should be able to exhibit what they are doing, and we should leave ordinary research we are doing at the school level, transform it into product that people can see and really take agriculture forward in this country. Definitely, I think these 3 days is going to be fantastic. I'm actually seeing it for the first time that people are actually believing in Nigeria as a country, and they are coming from other countries to come and exhibit here. So there is going to, it's going to be 3 days of great networking. It's going to be 3 days of education, and we're going to transfer technology. And we can now see those people that, those technology that we can actually use in this tropical part of the world, and those ones that are not just available, or the ones that we cannot do, basically because of our infrastructural challenges and power. So there is going to be a balance. We're going to be exposed to a lot of things that are working real time in some other part of the world. I think it's going to be a fantastic experience, meeting people from around the world in agricultural businesses.
Agro Innovate for me is an experience. The fact that all kinds of people in the agribusiness industry are here today to exchange ideas, and particularly to learn about what Nigeria is doing in transforming its agriculture. And I'm very happy about what is going on here. What we expect from Agro Innovate is that those of us who have come from far and near, we've been able to make business connections. And so when we go back, we'll be able to link up to industries and the people we've met in Nigeria to be able to continue the flow of goods and services in the agricultural sector in the sub-region.
Yeah, I think the impact will be immense if those of us that are here, we go back to tell one or two people, become like evangelists. Like I went through the exhibition, and I discovered at least one battery cage that has actually caught my attention, and I'll do my best to even, because I'm thinking of going to poultry, and if I have this, it will go a long way to help me as a person. I will employ some people, I will add value to poultry production in Nigeria. So that is just from my own side. Now think of about hundreds of people that are here now. If they get one or two things to go on with, it will surely impact upon Nigeria agriculture and economy. Yes, we are ready for mechanized agriculture, depending on who is driving the agricultural sector. We thank God for the Honorable Minister that we have presently, Dr. Akinwumi Adesina, that has taken the horn by the bull. One just praise that we have another driver after him that will sustain the level that he has attained. When he came, I will tell you that many years before now, we have never had what's called land development in Nigeria. But when he came, he saw it as a problem. The land development is a major problem for agricultural development. And he just plunged into land clearing of 6,400 hectares all over the country, and basically for cassava and rice. And not only that, he has also started mechanized cassava. That is the crop you least expected to be mechanized when you are talking of mechanization. Because cassava by nature does not easily lend itself to mechanization. But as I tell you, as I speak now, we have more than 3,000 hectares already established through mechanized agriculture. We have the apart from land clearing, the land preparation, we also have the planter for cassava. The spraying of chemicals or herbicide, everything mechanized. And the harvesting is going to be mechanized. So if we can mechanize cassava production, I don't see which other crop that we cannot mechanize again.
A lot of people that are here still believe or might have read it in books, some of these things, but now they are seeing it practically, and they will go all out there to go and confirm to all the agricultural practitioners or people in the business of agriculture to inform them in the most practical way, but that these things are handy, they are technology that can be used on the farm, and it's going to reduce the drudgery when it comes to agriculture, whereby the youth are saying, I can't do it because of this. With all of these that are available here, the equipment, the processing line, a lot of things, a lot of the youth can now be encouraged to go into agriculture because they will use less human power and more of the mechanical power.
I'm just very proud that he's back to Nigeria as the Minister of Agriculture, and all that he's doing today is everything that we have wished for every minister in the West African region to be. My only plea is that when he meets with his fellow ministers in the West African region, he should be able to pass on the experience and all that he's doing in Nigeria so that West Africa would also be able to stand on itself and produce and sustain everything for the industry.
So that's why His Excellency the President is so determined that we must grow this sector as a business that will allow us to reduce our dependency on food imports, make sure we can actually create jobs, revive our rural economy, and quite honestly, strengthen the Naira. So when you buy what we produce and we eat what we produce in Nigeria, you're actually boosting the economy, and that's the message.
Guys, our trivia question for today involves languages. You know you want to hear it, so stick around. We'll be right back.